one of the guys that are on the investigative
Simply in charge of the budget, and he noticed it.
You think the mayor should be impeached?
Oh, I think the mayor should absolutely be impeached. If he had any kind of morals at all, he would step in.
Okay, great. Thank you very much.
God bless.
So, how do you probably want to talk to you? Is this okay?
Yep. Okay.
Let me get your name.
I'm Scott Little.
Scott Little, okay. What's your thoughts about this? Why did you think it was important for you to be out here to support the this embattled councilman?
Well, it seems to me that with this whole thing with healthcare going on, that if you want to be a full-time employee, you're going to get city healthcare. And this is a case where we've had someone who doesn't work full-time and is the mayor of the girlfriend, and she's getting free healthcare courtesy of the city, courtesy of my taxes, which I can barely afford my healthcare. And I'm not really happy with my taxes going up each year and watching my, you know, watching my money go to somebody else.
Yeah, and tell me, but you're also troubled by the member of this special investigative panel too.
Yes, I understand. Dana Miles is the city attorney. Again, also is not a full-time city employee, but also gets paid city health care. And this person is on the panel that's investigating this insurance issue. It seems a little bit like there's a conflict of interest going on.
Yeah, so that upsets you as well.
Oh, very much.
Yeah,
Dana Miles should be removed from the board at least.
Yeah.
That's what it seems to me.
Okay, great. Thanks very much.
Thank
Appreciate
you.
It. It only states on there what the city pays for insurance, and that's it. No more information.
Is this is part of the matter this impeachment, or is there a bigger issue here? Is this a smokescreen? What's going on at 11 o'clock today?
Well, they're going to try to impeach the councilman, and if that happens, that is a court type charge. He will have to go through, I assume, their court. Probably similar to the kangaroo court that's taking place in this moment.
So, are there sides here? And do council members have some side with the mayor? I'm sorry, I don't have the background.
Well, not at this time, no. Nobody has come out publicly and said that they back Rupert Sexton. There's a couple of guys on there that I truly believe are honest men. There's some that's not. And So we'll see how it turns out in a few minutes. But regardless, I'm absolutely certain there'll be litigation if they decide to impeach. Everything that they've done has been unconstitutional. That's been stated by attorneys that this won't stay.
How about this, where do you see this going?
The word is to me that they're here to stay for a while. They're saying that this particular issue of this little insurance document is nothing. They got their hands on something much bigger.
Can you give me some background on how long has the mayor been here?
Over 40 years. 40 years. That has to tell you something right there.
And what's your understanding of who should get insurance?
Who what?
Who should be eligible for insurance? What is the...
City employees. No one else. Certainly not the county attorney. He's certainly able to pay for his own insurance. He doesn't have to be sponging off the city taxpayer. And the thing about it is, a lot of people feel that it is the county taxpayer who's funding this, because the loss and loss split here between Cumming and Forsyth County is way off base, way off base. The city only has a few residents, and the county has many, but the city gets not the lion's share, but gets a disproportionate share of the spoils and loss.
Looking back, as you have, how long have you been on the job in this?
Since 1998. So a long time. Oh, not as long as the mayor.
And is this just a litany of, is this just the latest chapter?
Well, it is. There's land transactions going on that I feel sure the FBI is investigating right now. And I feel sure that's going to be the real gist of this investigation. That this cracked open the case and brought it before the public. And there'll be lots more on this, you'd be assured of that.
So why has Rupert Sexton, why has he become the person that's on? Is this just...
Well, he is the one that asked for the paper to be made, the investigation and the printout to be made on who gets insurance paid by the city. And so when this popped out that the mayor's girlfriend is somehow on the list and she's not employed, that started the ball rolling. He gave it to some more commissioners, but I will tell you that I did not get the document from Rupert Sexton.
And the point of the impeachment is the public release of it.
It is, yeah. They claim things that are not in reality, like claiming that the release of information violated HIPAA. We are not supposed to give anybody's personal information, financial information, blah, blah, blah. But none of that happened. Only what each individual paid for insurance. That was it.
Can I see this document? Is it still posted?
It is. It is.
Where can I go to find it?
You can go to aboutforsyth.com, find it there. Nydia Tisdale runs that.
It's pretty much a spreadsheet.
It's a spreadsheet with just a list of employees and what they pay for insurance, or what the city pays for the employees.
I don't like where if you went to find their public web, their salary, is that kind of thing?
Oh, absolutely. An open record is accessible by them.
All right, I'll join you upstairs. Anything else I should touch on that I didn't with you?
Well, we really appreciate the news media taking attention to this, and we hope you stick around for now. It should be exciting.
Okay, thanks, sir. I appreciate it. I'll let you get back to it. If nothing else, you got a hell of an arm there.
All right.
You kept it up the whole time.
All right. Did you get anything? Good.
Okay, that's where I'm going. Okay, thank you. Oh, it's still the same ones.
Yes. Since
they,
the building
they don't
was
have built. A lot of turnover here, do they?
Apparently not, no. I think the last council took office because of someone who passed away.
Saying that they're going to be here for a while. So that probably will tell me this. Good seeing you again.
You too.
All right, buddy.
What a beautiful day for a rally. Couldn't ask for any better weather.
It's really nice.
Works out.
They have so much money, they can afford it themselves.
She has a full-time job for an attorney's office. Let her
Dana
be on
Miles.
Let her be on their health insurance.
And Dana Miles, right. He can afford his own insurance.
Now, Dana, he's the county attorney or something?
City attorney.
Okay. He is not an employee, neither is...
He can afford his own insurance.
He doesn't qualify for health insurance, yet he's getting it.
No, but he's not considered a city employee because he's his own office holder, a constitutional office. I don't know.
It's an appointed position, I believe, to be the city attorney.
He's a subcontractor.
Yes.
He's paid an hourly fee for a reported service. We don't know what Ms. Mullinax is paid.
All right.
He's paid in healthcare.
I don't know what her dues
are. I wouldn't want her dues.
Yeah, wouldn't be worth it.
Thank you. Excellent. How about you?
Good. I'm Bob Moore.
I'm George Hay.
Hey, George. How are you?
Not a resident of the city, but of the county.
But we're taxpayers.
Yep.
Yep. We fund the city. Thank you.
You're looking good.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm probably older than you think.
How old?
27.
See, I had that same problem.
Yes, ma'am.
I would guess you to be like 20.
Yeah.
It's okay.
I'm in my like 40s, so I know.
Yeah,
you know. Yeah. I started to teach school at 22, and they used to ask for my hall pass. And I was like 29, and expecting my first child, and they were like,
both sides of the story. Okay, that's good to hear. Yeah, I'm going to ask that we see us
back. Yeah, I'm going to ask that we see us back. Yeah, I'm
going to ask that we
You're filming and whatnot.
How are you?
Here comes Mr. Miles.
Where's he at?
Rupert Sexton.
I'm sorry, can you all, that's my camera.
Sorry.
It's okay. It's hard to know.
I think Rupert Sexton is an honest man, and he's trying to do the right thing by exposing this, and look what happened to him when he tried to do the right thing. The whistleblowers shouldn't be the ones who get in trouble. They're the ones that are trying to help. It's unfortunate when the whistleblowers have the attention calmed down, and they're the ones now doing the right thing.
I'm
not a resident of the city.
How long have you been watching?
I've actually just got
get involved. How can we not? When this healthcare is such an issue in this country, and people can't afford it, and then we've got people that are basically data miles, Angie Mullinax, and Mayor Graves are the ones who need to prosecute the Rupert
Honey, don't get it.
Appreciate it. Here we go.
Yeah, that's good.
Dave, go over there to stand by Michelle. He's over there by
don't
Terry.
Don't say anybody's name.
Terry, would you get in and bring them, David?
Have a little more.
Name's Chad.
Yeah, that's good.
I'm not afraid.
You're going to get on it.
Hello.
Hello. Tax free.
News channel is on the job.
We're streaming live. We got 18 viewers.
That's
right. Hey,
what's the start? Possum News Channel.
That's it. Possum up.
Woo!
Possum up. Better than a possum down.
Nice. Jim, good looking bunch of people.
What about your possum hat? You found it yet?
We're working on it. I can't find one with that cute little tail on the back.
I'm doing good. They
oh, hey, but you got I'm going to look at them in the sun. I can see them. Hey, man. Yeah,
I just caught you.
Oh, my God.
Okay, she got hurt.
Yo, check it out. Check it out. Look, look over there.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
Good.
Yeah. Kangaroo Court, now in session. Check this out.
Oh, nice. Woo!
Okay, that brings more attention.
Way upstairs.
The weather. That's okay. It's
a little windy when you get up to altitude. It has downed the Forsyth County drone. Video drone today was down due to weather conditions.
There it is.
How am I supposed to know? I never would expect it. Don't get arrested today, honey, and then she shows up. You should have brought the black belt over.
She's got it.
And you don't have it?
I have it, but after 5 years, it wind conditions.
That makes sense.
Well, they can't handle the high wind.
Today?
No, the other day. Caught it up high above the tree, so it was covering. I basically just had to take it into a free fall to get it back.
You know? Wow.
And, you know, it was down high, but it gave a really nice shot. You can't get a shot like that from a plane or, you know, helicopter. We've already had our live broadcast, had 18 viewers on there watching it.
Our president would have sent somebody down here to take you. They send them everywhere else. So.
They stated that if they went forward with impeachment, that they would step in.
Okay, good. Yeah, that's kind of ridiculous. Now you break something out in the open. I guess that's the way they do it. They want to attack you. So that's the prime way to try to get somebody out of their way is try to attack you. I've never known you to do anything, huh?
No, I haven't done anything.
Always been a good, integrity man.
Than a possum down.
Yeah. I'm going in. Y'all get yourselves in there in a few
minutes. We'll be in there in a moment. In fact, I'm going to go check it out.
I grabbed your sign for you so they won't get you for littering. You see, now I'm on the right. You see? Little?
Thank you.
we just leave him outside?
I would.
I don't want to leave him outside.
Hello.
No, I don't. Oh, cool. Thank you. Oh, appreciate it.
I like your hat.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Everyone. I could ask everyone to silence their phone, please cut the phone off or put it on silence, and please stand and join me in the pledge of flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Call this meeting for the purpose of receiving the investigative report of the panel that was empowered by the City Council on December the 23rd in reference to the report of personal and private information on city employees and for the possible impeachment of Rupert Sexton. I'll turn it over to City Investigative Committee Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, members of council. If I may approach, I have a copy of our report I'd like to deliver to each of you.
Yes.
Mayor, with your permission, I'd like to read the report at this time. This is the report and recommendation of the investigatory panel to the City Council of Cumming regarding Councilman Rupert Sexton. The undersigned panel was appointed by resolution of the City Council to investigate, quote, whether evidence exists to support charges that Councilman Rupert Sexton has conducted himself in a way that falls within the purview of conduct prohibited by Section 51 of the Charter of the City of Cumming, Georgia, end quote. The panel has examined documents and interviewed witnesses. Despite requests, Councilman Sexton, Dana Sexton, and David Milam refused to appear to be interviewed by the panel. Based upon the witnesses who did appear and the relevant documents, the panel finds that there is evidence to support the charges. It is also possible that Councilman Sexton, Dana Sexton, or David Milam may have evidence that could refute those charges. The panel is concerned with two legal issues and recommends that prior to any further action being taken in the impeachment process, that these issues be addressed by the City Council requesting an opinion from the Attorney General of Georgia or by filing a declaratory judgment action in Superior Court. The issues are, number one, does Section 51 of the Charter of the City of Cumming, Georgia, as supplemented by Section 2-20 of the City Ordinances adopting Robert's Rules of Order, provide sufficient due process for the impeachment process under both the Georgia and the U.S. Constitution? Number two, does the release of city employee financial data or information other than compensation and or city employee health insurance information violate OCGA section 50-18-72A subsections 20 through 21 in that it discloses financial data and insurance information in public records, or the Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act of 1996, HIPAA, in that it violates the HIPAA privacy rules? Having completed their duties as required by the City Council, the panel requests that they be discharged. This is the 28th day of January, 2014, respectfully submitted and signed by Patrick Bell, Steve Page, and myself, Dana Miles. That's our report, Mr. Mayor, and our recommendation.
Thank you very much. Okay, the first time I think is probably the dismissal of the board.
To discharge the panel because we've completed our duties. That's our request.
That was appointed on December the 23rd. First of all, let me thank Mr. Bell, Mr. Page, and Mr. Miles for their participation in the investigation. And even though
it's a real investigation,
we have concerns here, mm-hmm. I know we all took some time to go through the interviews and the documents that the board requested of you, and we certainly, on behalf of the board, appreciate that. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
He should be impeached. He's the one who should be impeached.
I hear a motion to dismiss the board.
So moved.
Second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. 5-0. Okay, the recommendation by the board now is that we send this to the Attorney General for a review of the process and these two items, that legal issues that concerns their city attorney. Is that correct?
Yes, sir, and the panel.
And the panel. So what's the pleasure of the board? I have a motion from John D. to have a second.
What exactly is the motion?
To send the two items that legal concerns of the Mr. Miles gave you a copy of that, the right. Two items of legal concern. Does and I'll read both of them. Does 51 of the Charter of the City of Cumming, Georgia, as supplemented by 2-20 of the City Ordinance adopting Robert's Rules of Order, provide sufficient due process for the impeachment process under both the Georgia and U.S. Constitution? And the second one, does the release of city employee financial data or information other than compensation and or by city employee health insurance information violate OCGA 50-18-72A 20-21 in that it discloses financial data and insurance information in public records or the Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act of 1996, HIPAA, in that it violates the HIPAA privacy rule. So that's the two items that's been recommended by the panel to go get a ruling on, and we have a motion to that effect. We're looking for a second.
I'll second.
I'll second from Lewis. Any discussion on this?
Just to send it to the Attorney General to get his recommendation or his ruling.
Requesting an opinion from the Attorney General of Georgia by filing a declaratory judgment action in Superior Court. The issue is yet.
Let's get a little closer and narrow it down a little. Is this, you're asking the Attorney General to review these two items. What about the impeachment? Is we supposed to be here for today?
We have a recommendation by the board that the sufficient evidence that's concerned, and we'd like to have a ruling from the Attorney General, is my understanding. Is that correct, counsel?
Yes, sir. I believe the panel's recommendation is to seek a ruling, an opinion, an official opinion from the Attorney General. If for whatever reason the Attorney General did not issue an opinion, I guess the backup or alternative recommendation would be that the panel recommended the City Council consider filing a declaratory judgment in Superior Court. Those are actually two different things, but I believe the way the Council is proceeding right now is the appropriate way to go, and that was why the panel listed that first. Let's seek an opinion from the Attorney General as on these two legal issues before we proceed any further in the impeachment process. Thank you.
Have a motion and a second. All in favor signify by raising your hand. Four. All opposed?
Opposed.
All opposed, raise your hand. You voted to oppose or in favor?
Not in favor.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Four for and one against. Rupert Sexton, councilman, opposed. That completes the business to come forth this meeting. I hear a motion to adjourn.
I make a motion.
Second.
Second.
All in favor signify by raising your hand. Thank you very much. Thank y'all.
For your health care, Angie. Angie, are we going to continue to pay for your health care?
Please.
Okay.
I'm so sorry, sir.
I didn't want to be the first one to go into jail. Why would I go to jail for asking a question while she's stealing our money?
That is smart. And I've never heard it again.
Once again, it's a bit of a design.
Yeah, right.
Hey, yeah, but thanks, mate.
Hey, I seen your name, and I can't stop you talking. Yeah, oh yeah. I'm
little too.
At 8:11.
What are you doing?
I know we've all put all the weight off in here.
Yep. Sure have. Bunch of it.
Did you want to give a statement here, sir?
Do an interview out there? Yeah.
So talk to me, do you think that perhaps the step of contacting the Attorney General should have been taken before they created this investigative panel?
I agree with that.
What was that?
I agree that they should have already cleared that up before now.
What do you make of the process that was done here to try to impeach you?
It's just another way to embarrass me. I'm not done yet.
The mayor's gotten a lot of heat for giving his girlfriend free health care benefits.
Oh, I'm sure I got a lot of heat.
Was this an attempt to hide that? What do you make of this whole process?
Farce. This is just get Rupert Sexton. Because Rupert Sexton revealed information. Or I didn't reveal any information, but it was revealed to the public, which is public record, that there are people on the city health plan that's not supposed to be there. And the taxpayers are paying for it. I work for the citizens of Cumming. They're the people, the taxpayers. I don't work for the mayor, and I don't work for the city council.
Was this unconstitutional in your mind?
Yes, I do.
And what do you expect the Attorney General to say after this has been sent to him?
Same thing.
What's that?
It's unconstitutional.
Sir, how did you feel the proceedings went? Did you expect to have a forum? Did you expect a vote on impeachment? What did you think?
Yeah, I expected a vote on impeachment. Sure did.
And this tactic today, is it putting it down the road? How do you see it?
It's just an easy way out for them. They've dug their hole. They always told me, if you dig into the ditch, you can't get out of it. You need to stop digging.
Councilman Sexton, I'm sorry. We had some technical problems down on our truck, so I missed what happened. Can you explain what happened and your reaction to that, please?
They didn't do anything. They put everything in the lap of the Attorney General. I've already had an attorney to research this.
And how would you characterize this action by counsel?
It's just kangaroo court. Is all it is.
Does it deny your opportunity to prove your case?
Right. Basically, yeah.
Is it going to cost you money personally?
Oh yeah, I'm going to have to hire an attorney.
Are you going to have to hire an attorney? The Attorney General.
Well, no.
Comes back and says that you did nothing wrong, then chances are that's where this stops.
That's right. I have information that if they did go forward with impeachment, that the Attorney General would step in.
And so do you think they realized that they had no legal standing to do anything against you, and that's why they took this action?
I think so.
Do you perceive this as retaliation for embarrassing the mayor?
Oh, yes, there ain't no doubt about that. You don't have to be a rocket scientist to figure that out.
Why is this just an injustice for all the taxpayers out there?
What?
Why is this an injustice for all the taxpayers out there?
I didn't do anything illegal. I did not release a list. Not only did I not release a list, the list was given to somebody walked in off the street by Dana Miles' his assistant. I believe her name is Rebecca Williams. So if it's so bad, they're saying that my list or whose list, whoever list it is, if that is so bad and so illegal, why is the city attorney's assistant passing it out, handing it out? Think about it.
What about for the mayor's next move? I mean, we asked him and he said he'll deal with it at another time. He was questioned about the legality of his wife being on the list just in the last few minutes. His girlfriend, excuse me. What, is there anything the council, where's this going?
I don't know. Somebody needs to do something beside me.
Are you going to make a motion to try to impeach the mayor now?
I'm not going to answer that.
Well, you are the council, though. So, I mean, does the council have the ability to do that?
It's being researched.
So what's the next step?
The Attorney General, everything is going to the Attorney
All
General.
All the findings of this investigation, and then he'll rule whether to proceed further with it?
Right.
Uh-huh. Does he have the authority to impeach you?
The
Attorney General?
Council. No, the council don't either.
Okay, so what could be the possible outcomes of the recommendation?
Everything be dismissed.
Or you could say that there are grounds for impeachment?
Yeah.
And it would be turned over to the court here in Forsyth County.
Right.
Okay.
But I get some idea. You have some idea how this is going to come out.
Yes.
What's that?
No, I'm not going to answer that.
Okay. All right. Thanks.
Okay.
All right.
Great.
Thank you.
Want to give a shout out and walking down the stairs?
Were you surprised by what happened?
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Hey.
Just came out of the store.
There we go.
He doesn't deserve it. Your time, which I'm sure you understand.
Put it out of that.
Joy Bowling. Do you know Joy Bowling?
Yeah.
They were talking to her.
She's my favorite.
I ain't
been
with her.
So I pray for her.
Did he say anything? Did he make himself available?
Yeah, not really. He was walking away from me, and I just, like, chased after him.
Is he still here?
Yeah. Yeah, and his girlfriend's back there, too.
I said, okay, Phil. No one's sitting here. They don't all use keys.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
All of your support.
They don't have
to.
It's been
a long
time.
The world's there,
maybe. I overthought. Some people use passwords.
Excuse me.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And on the
Sorry.
And on one vote, the guy on the far right voted yes and no.
That was the end vote. I'm not sure. I don't remember what that was.
They didn't know what they were doing now.
What exactly is the motion again? John, last name was, so I couldn't see it.
But, stood up and tried to explain. Yeah, they were all
it seemed good.
Where's the mayor's office? Downstairs?
Just right back through there. It's locked.
You can't get in any other way? There's no lobby?
No.
Aren't pass keys just handed out willy-nilly, though?
Yeah, you can come down. He won't be coming down.
No. Oh, no. He's here.
He ain't coming out.
No what?
Ain't no way.
That's lovely.
That's a good picture, too.
Congratulations to you, babe.
I think I spoke to him last night.
Got it.
I knew that's how
you
were. Thanks.
I'd
work for
Chef
in a big old box.
He's like, y'all don't mean you're digging a hole and you don't stop digging.
Stop.
Only surprised that the level is going to be too
good.
People in these roles. It's an embarrassment. Forsyth County is growing by leaps and bounds, and to have people like this running our city is an embarrassment.
How about the, as far as nobody's bringing it up in council at their discretion, the mayor's situation with the health care? So we have the impeachment issue, but what can the populace, is there a movement afoot?
I hope so. Through our Facebook groups, and we're all active on social media, and we're sharing with our friends and our relatives and trying to get more people involved. To me, the issue is not impeachment. The issue is breaking the law. The mayor put his girlfriend on the city health insurance that the city has paid for. So in turn, the Forsyth County taxpayers have put that bill. And with so many people in our county that are suffering and don't have health insurance, to find out there's a woman on there who is not an employee of the county but simply the girlfriend of the mayor, he should be ashamed of himself, as should she. She has a full-time job with a law firm. She can either afford to pay for her own health insurance or she should get it through her employer. The city should not be paying for it.
Mm-hmm. What would you, was she in court? Or was
yes,
she
was here.
She was here?
She rushed out right after the vote. She didn't stick around.
Sure, I got a picture of her.
She's a shorter lady, very short.
So, I'd love to see.
Okay, and the Attorney General will look at the.
Have a look at those two items. That,
I'm going to go down.
He will look at these two items that I've already questioned. That's the items he's going to look at. See, I've already questioned.
Congratulations.
Oh, thank you.
I'm going to take a picture of these two in case, but I'm going to tackle the insurance thing. Separate ticket. Yeah.